Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. It's Monique here. I know it's been a minute since you guys have seen me last, but I promise it's for a good reason. Today I'm going to be drawing a picture of a hammerhead shark, of course doing it in graphite realism as usual because that's my strong suit as an artist, but I'm going to be doing it with a twist today. I want to push myself out of my comfort zone and because I want to grow as an artist. I want to do different things. I don't want to just stay with graphite for the rest of my life. So I'm doing a watercolor background. This is the first time I'm doing watercolor, so bear with me. It's all a learning lesson, and I want to share that with you guys and to hopefully inspire you that, hey, if I can do a piece for the first time and it can come out decent, then you can do it too. Before we get into the video, please subscribe down below if you haven't done so yet, and I hope you guys enjoy this.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Hey all, so you made it to the end of the video. I definitely learned a lot from this piece. I had so much fun, don't get me wrong, because doing color is just something so different than graphite. I will always love graphite with all of my heart. That's like my roots as an artist, but something so just experimentative and creativity can really come out of color. Not that it can't with graphite, but it's just a whole new world. You're kind of in a box with graphite, you know what I mean? But so what I pretty much learned as far as the shark goes, that was easy. Took me about 3.5 hours, nothing too crazy. The texture was very simple compared to the last couple of videos that I have uploaded here. Just a very smooth texture because sharks have smooth skin. So I just used an HB mechanical pencil for the entire thing, and I used my blending stumps to smoothen it out. I really took my time making sure that the texture was just super smooth and not streaky at all. And I didn't add any highlighting to it really, just a tiny bit, because honestly, the piece didn't really need it. It just didn't. It's under the water, and I was just trying to capture the ray of lights, the rays of light coming down in from the ocean. And as far as the watercolor goes, well, I did a couple before this final product, and I had to rip them up into a bunch of pieces because, like I said, this is the first time I did watercolor. And if you don't know, which I didn't know, if you use too much water on the paper almost starts to disintegrate a little bit. It kind of leaves like a little residue and it ruins the entire piece. So I did that a couple of times by accident, but I learned. So by this time, I was pretty happy with the final product. It's weird for me because I'm so used to doing hyper realistic drawings. So watercolor is definitely not the paint to use if you're going for a hyper realistic look. You know, it's more fun. It's more like abstracty and just like I said, it's more of a fun type of paint. No rules outside of the lines kind of a thing where it's not as like precise as maybe acrylic or oil paint. So yeah, that's what I learned from this. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Like I said, I know I had so much fun, and hey, that's the whole point of doing art. It's supposed to be fun and expressive. If you haven't done so yet, please subscribe to my channel and give this video a like if you enjoyed it. And if you're interested in purchasing this piece, it will be available on my Etsy page and it's in the description box below. I love you guys so much. I seriously appreciate all the support you guys continuously show me. And until then, I'll see you next time.